Moana Uta has been a marine reserve since 2005, and now we're right down the head of Wet Jacket Arm. So it's a whole fjord. Moana Uta actually means the inland sea. So we're right in amongst all of these mountains. You can see that the walls of the fjords are so steep up here. So you can imagine that this place doesn't get much sunlight in the marine environment because of all the shading, and it doesn't get much wave energy from the ocean swell. So you don't get those big kelp forests all washing around in the waves, and you don't get that sunlight and all of that water movement, real lush kelp forest growing and lots of phytoplankton that fuels the marine environment, that all of the animals underneath. So when we go diving today, you know, usually you'd think, oh, we'll jump in the marine reserve and we'll see way more than we saw yesterday when we weren't in a marine reserve. But we're actually in a really different kind of environment. So it's a lower energy environment. We will see like fallen trees and animals that have found their homes on the trees. And the seafloor will look like the base of the forest when we're doing our forest walks. The really amazing thing about fjordland is that you'll notice that all around us in the catchments is this incredibly lush rainforest. And it's a really productive forest in itself. So you've been for a walk in the bush, everything is just covered in growth. And that finds its way into the marine environment through landslides that happen when there's big storms or big earthquakes that just shove all of that energy, all of that carbon that's been captured from the forest and the sunlight down into the marine environment. Today we're going to go for a dive across the delta, which is like the coastal wetland. So there's a big river that comes in, carrying all of that energy from the forest and in the form of kind of mud and sticks and leaves and tree trunks, and it plops it all down on this big kind of mud flat that we're going to swim across. And you might think, oh, boring, we're going to go look at some mud. But the cool thing about mud is that inside the mud there are all these animals working away to munch up all of that forest material. So there's special worms and urchins that burrow through the mud. And they gobble it up and can digest it, and then the fish can come along, and the crayfish and whoever else, and they can feed on all of the animals that are living in that mud. And so you get this crazy thing happening where the animals that live in here in the sea actually get most of their energy from the forest, which is probably how it used to be way back in the days before all the forests were, you know, burnt down and cut down and turned into farmland around New Zealand. So this is like a fully intact ecosystem from the tops of the mountains to the depths of the fjords. One of the really special features about this marine reserve, which has really excited us, is that we're seeing fish that we thought were only sort of deep sea fish finding their home again back in the shallows in this marine reserve. And so if we're lucky enough, we might be able to see harpooka, grouper, bass. So the fact that we can now potentially go swimming with them here in this amazing special marine reserve, it's just like such a great example of how when you remove that fishing pressure, things can restore themselves back to the way that they used to be. So fingers crossed we get to swim with the harpooka today. I'm really excited about that.
I liked when we swam through all the jellyfish. It was real cool seeing the baby ones, which are like the size of my fingernail. And we saw lots of cool fish, and it was cool kind of seeing an underwater forest.
My highlights were the big humongous fish swimming underneath you. I think marine reserves are important because they protect our species, and it's just quite cool to see that there's going to be more and we can just see the changes that are happening.